Eric Becker, the naturopath. Thanks for coming back to my channel. Right, we're going to do an interesting video this morning. I've made a video like this a few years ago, but I'm not sure if it's still sort of floating around on the internet. So we're going to talk about the color of stool, all right? It's very interesting. So people like me often get to talk about poop all the time to patients. The color of poop, the texture of poop, what it smells like. It's probably not your cup of tea, right? Probably not the type of job that you would like to do. But for me, well, it's just part of being the kind of, you know, healthcare person that I am. I mean, we talk about bowel problems all the time with people. After all, we always all have to poop. If we don't poop, then we die, apparently. So when I started thinking about this video, I thought, what am I going to call it? 50 Shades of Brown? The Scoop on Poop? Don't know. But anyway, this is one of the areas I often have a lot of fun with when I used to do my presentations, public presentations many years ago. So, you know, talk about this and show people different colors on the screen and things like that. So let's talk a little bit about the color of stool and what it means. The different colors I've put down here are brown, green, dark brown, black almost kind of color, a yellow and a red color. So the brown's the most common color that you'll see, all right? But you'll see all sorts of shades of brown, from very pale tan, a cream, you know, sort of right up to dark brown, even like black. So the brown color is quite normal, and it's bile basically being produced by the gallbladder and spent blood cells. So the brown color is a consequence of bacteria acting upon the stool to make it that color, but also red blood cells make it that are used up, make it that sort of dark brown color. So that's the normal color that it should be. The texture should be sort of not too soft, not too hard. If you bake cakes or do a lot of baking, you sort of get to work out textures of things, you know. So stool's a bit the same. When you look at it enough times and you're talking enough times, you get to know there's a certain texture of the stool. So you don't want it too sloppy, too loose. You don't want it too firm or hard. Go to Google and have a look at the Bristol stool chart. B-R-I-S-T-O-L, Bristol stool chart. And it'll give you an idea, because you've got sheep pellets on one end and you've got the cow pats on the other end, all right? And sort of got the normal cigar-shaped stool in the middle. So it's important not just to look at the color of the stool, but also the texture and the odor and everything about the stool. Some people's, you know, bowel motions are pretty nasty. You know, you can't really go near the bathroom for, you know, sometimes a whole lot of time because it's pretty bad. My dad was like that. And you'll probably know, maybe, you know, a family member or friend like that where, you know, it's pretty nasty and you can't go anywhere near that bathroom. See, that's a problem, because that tells me the person's got a real issue with their diet. They're obviously eating far too much of one thing. They're not eating the right kind of food. They could have a medical complaint, but more likely it's just like my dad. They'd eat a whole packet of cookies and maybe three cups of coffee with three or four sugars, you know, in each coffee. Well, that's a problem. You know, your gut's not going to like that much, and it's going to produce pretty bad bowel motions. So same with people who eat far too much fat. You know, some people like huge amount of steak with lots of fat on it, and, you know, and if your gallbladder or liver and stomach aren't up to that kind of capacity, you can have pretty nasty bowel motions. So brown's the color we want. You know, 1 to 2 bowel motions a day is quite normal. Easy elimination, you know, not a lot of time spent there really in the bathroom. And there should be a good sense of relief when you've had a motion. You should feel like really emptied out. That's what a healthy person has. A couple of habits I've tried to work with patients over the years to try and correct the bad habits is particularly going to the bathroom, sitting on the toilet, and trying to force that motion out really quick because you want to go and do something else, right? This is a habit that some people have, especially with overactive thyroids. They'll often try and force bowel motions out. Other people will sit there for ages reading a newspaper, or they'll be going through their mobile phones. Ladies probably don't do that, but I'll tell you now, the guy toilets, you go to the men toilets, you'll be hearing a guy all of a sudden, you'll hear a random conversation coming out of a cubicle and be a guy talking on his phone to some other guy or a woman or something. Anyway, got sidetracked there, but brown is good, all right? Brown's the color we want. Green, ever heard of green stools? It can often happen with a diet change. So if a person rapidly changes their diet over to a high vegetable diet, You'll find some babies or young children commonly get green stools, which I'll explain in a minute. Some adults get it too. So when you first sort of got my kind of work and someone says, guess what, I had a green bowel motion, you know, you might think, well, maybe they're off their head or something, because I've never heard of green bowel motions. But green bowel motions aren't that, you know, aren't that rare. They're quite common. So it takes time for bacteria to act on stool. Sometimes if a person's got a problem with their bile, you know, especially their gallbladder, they can have a green stool problem. With children, often it means they're eating too quick, too fast, too high veggie intake, and their liver and tiny gallbladder hasn't got enough oomph or power to convert, you know, that greeny colour to a browny colour because of the bacteria. You know, insufficient bacteria or some sort of weakness going on there, or the stool's going too quick, you know, through the gut for it to be modified from a greenish colour to a brownish colour. And that can happen sometimes with diarrhea or infectious disease, which is quite common with kids. They tend to have much faster moving digestive tracts than adults do. So green stool can happen, like chopped spinach, for example. I've seen that with some children, you know, with you know, who are getting sick, basically children with all kinds of immune dysfunctions. This can happen. But adults as well, of course. The dark colour, really dark brown, sometimes bordering on black, that can be a cause of concern, especially if it's a tarry stool and it's like really loose and sticky and smelly and big, a really problematic stool. That could indicate melanemia, which is like a bit of blood in the stool. So that will definitely need investigation, especially if the patient's very fatigued or extremely tired with those kind of stools. There can be internal bleeding, it can be a lack of iron. In some cases, it can be taking far too much iron supplement. And in children, we know that iron supplements can kill them, really young children, so you need to be careful. So very suspicious looking dark or sludgy kind of black stools, you need to be straight off to the doctor and get that checked out, because that, you know, it could be anything, but it's always worth checking out. What about yellow stool? Yellow, isn't that a weird one? Or a really pale stool? That can indicate a pancreatic dysfunction or a liver dysfunction, see? So you can see how the colours can indicate different organ kind of problems. Pancreatic dysfunction can occur, especially if the person feels a bit nauseous or queasy or burpy or bloaty, or they don't feel quite right in the upper digestive system. There could be some pain radiating towards the back that could indicate gallstones. That's not uncommon, especially in women, you know, sort of 40, 50s. Gallstones are relatively common today. So yeah, the patient may need checking out for gallstones, especially if they fart a lot and they bloat a lot and the stools are a yellowy colour. In that case, I'd look at the tongue of the person to see how flabby it is and how scalloped the edges are, because that could often indicate a liver problem. So have a look at the tongue, and then also the diet. I mean, are they drinking a lot of wine, far too much wine? Are they eating a lot of crisps, too much fatty food? Too much cheese, too much processed cheese, you know, with that plastic on it. That's just crap, that stuff. But you get my point. Just too much rich stuff. And that can make the digestive organs have to work in overload. And in that case, the stool will change because the digestive capacity is not really there anymore. And that will come often associated with, again, tiredness or fatigue or sleeping disturbances. So that's the yellowy or pale kind of stool. Especially if the person's losing a lot of weight or getting thin and poor appetite and nausea, I'd be thinking a little bit more about pancreas. And then I'd be doing an amylase test, be checking the enzymes in the stool to see where the amylase is, to see if they've got enough, you know, pancreatic power to really work on the food. Red stools can come about, but rarely, and that'll be bleeding. So the brighter the blood, the more likely it's to be a hemorrhoid or a lower down problem. The darker the blood, the more likely it's bleeding from higher up in the digestive system, where it's been, you know, it's been acted upon with enzymes or bacteria that will be higher up in the gut. But lower down, especially with wiping, if you notice red, that will denote often a hemorrhoid. So that's a bit my take on the different stool colours, but there's way more to it than that. But that's just a real quick, brief overview on the scoop on poop. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll catch up with you guys later.